everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And today is our first day in the garden. Believe it or not, it's almost 60 degrees out. But if you look behind me, we still have 2 feet of snow. Now I want you to look across the driveway and suddenly we have spring. And now I can see that where I didn't get to finish my iris bed last fall, I'm going to work today and get a head start on it so that when they start growing, it'll all be nice and clean. But I want you to see something else. This is our new baby, Pepper. Hi, Pepper. We've had her 1 week. She's 4 months old. And she is a standard poodle.
And she's going to be your garden assistant, right?
She is. She's going to eat up all the bad things in the garden. Yes, you, Pepper. She's a happy little dog. We're glad we got her.
She is sweet. She loves to snuggle.
Right. Now, of course, Jingle, our other dog, is rather annoyed with her because Pepper wants to play. She's a puppy, and Jingle doesn't want to. Pepper, what's that noise? Scary, isn't it? Now let's see what I have that needs to be cleaned up. The first thing you're going to see with Iris are the old leaves. So all of that has to be cleaned out. All of the leaves that came down from the trees need to be cleaned out. And these big branches that have fallen out of the tree, we don't need in here either. So this whole area right here is full of bearded iris and it all has to be cleaned. Now this will not go in the compost because iris are notorious for having borers. Insects that go in through the roots and eat their way and lay eggs and have larvae that's chewing on everything. So you don't want to take any chance of spreading that by putting contaminated old pieces of the plant into your compost. So this all has to go in the garbage. Quite easy to get them out of there. They're loose with just a little tugging and a little bit of jiggling. Get them out of there. Ooh, looks better already. And you can see, even though today is one of the first days that are in above freezing, they're already growing. And you can also see that this is the creeping marigold that took over here, and it's still here.
Is that a marigold?
Remember those creeping, what was that? Creeping something that we had in here. Creeping buttercup.
Buttercup,
Creeping buttercup that we put in here thinking that it would be pretty. Well, no, it took over. So this is a good time to catch that also before it gets carried away. Now, on the individual plant, this is the old stem from one of the flowers, but you see down here, I'm just gonna peel off these leaves that I don't like. Don't like the looks of those. And then I'm gonna dig out the creeping buttercup. Now, if you accidentally pull out an iris or dig one up, you just put it back in. But look at the roots on that. This is why this was a bad choice on our part.
It was pretty.
It was very pretty, yes.
Like a blanket.
And if we hadn't had something else in here, it would have been nice. Or if we would have had a hillside where we didn't want the soil to wash away. That would have been a nice soil retainer.
Well, I know some of your viewers have asked about planting iris and why they don't bloom.
Well, sometimes it's because they don't get enough sun. They like lots of sun. And sometimes it's maybe you put them in too deeply. They don't like to be deep. They like to have part of their
rhizome
up in the
exposed.
Yeah, out of the soil. So cleaning up is probably the most time-consuming for iris. Once they get going. Oh yeah, but once they get going, they are not picky. You don't have to water them. You don't really have to fertilize them. Well, we never fertilize them. As long as you keep track of them and keep them clean, that's the best thing you could do for iris.
Well, plus you have music playing for the iris all the time anyhow throughout
yes,
the winter, so it keeps them entertained.
Mm-hmm. And me as well. Two people working makes it go much faster. Rick took the rake and gently raked the big stuff off. Now that can go over in another area far away from our iris, so that doesn't need to be bagged up and thrown away. But you can see this is how it looks once I'm done. And then that is still needs to be cleaned. But once it gets to this point where most of it looks like the old leaves are gone, you're gonna see some damage like this that could be from frost. This, because I have it clean now, I'll be able to tell if there's a problem once the summertime comes and the actual growth starts taking place. Then I can address it.
Well, what are some of the conditions that you look for in the actual leaf structure?
Well, you're going to look for leaves that turn brown or have brown spots or get squishy. They shouldn't be squishy. They should be tall, firm leaves that have no puffiness to them. So if you see something that looks like it's getting brown spots, a leaf that's getting brown spots, you may want to dig up that one and look, and you will probably find an iris borer, which you can then chop off that part of the root system, clean it off with a little bit of chlorine bleach and water, and then replant it, possibly in a little different area because there still could be iris borer eggs and things in there.
And if you ignore it?
If you ignore it, it'll spread all over.
Yep.
Bad news. And there's no way you can just spray and kill them all. It just doesn't work that way. It's a one by one thing. It's one thing about iris. And once they're happily growing, they're happy. But if something comes along, you have to take care of it right away. Well, about an hour has gone by, and look at the difference. Two people working for 1 hour. It looks like a whole new garden. Will it snow on it again? Yes, probably. Will it hurt them? No, they're tough. But this will give them a good clean start for next spring, for summer. And got two bags of garbage that'll be going in, and clean up the edge, looks so much better.
You want to say hi to everybody? Oh yeah. Well, sure. Hey, bring that scissors back here. You do not walk off with the scissors. Pepper, get over here. Bring that scissors back. She's bringing it to you, Lynn.
Ruby, thank you. Thank you.
Such a helpful pooch. Think she'll make a great gardener.
We've mentioned the damage that iris borer do to your irises. And as you're digging around, you may find evidence that they're already in your garden. Well, that's what I have found at least twice now. And I'll show you what it looks like. Okay. This is the iris plant. This is a very healthy part of the plant and has nice roots. But you can see that something last summer attacked this part of the rhizome, and it made it rotten and hollow, and you can see how damaged that is. Now, iris are so tough that they can go beyond what has happened to them and continue to grow. But in order to assure that this is going to be a healthy little one, I'm going to cut this off, this damaged part. And you see that there is no damage to that right there. That is a nice, healthy piece of iris root. So let me find that one that I just... Where did it go?
Over there, yeah.
Well, that's another one.
Yeah.
All right, let me pull that one out.
I knew you were on a mission when you were digging in this particular area.
I was looking for that little piece I cut off, and now I lost it.
That one right there?
No, the part that I cut off of here. It flew over that way.
Oh.
All right, now let's look at this one. Here again, you can see down underneath where the larvae of the borer have chewed that up. Now this is a earthworm there. All right, but again, they are so resilient that they'll just keep on growing. So I'm going to break that off. Now you can see, before I put my dirty glove on there, that there was still a little brown piece there, which I'm going to take off. Okay, so now it's clean. There is no damage there. This one is soft, but it seems to have healed up. And this part is perfectly fine. So I will plant this. Look at those nice healthy roots. I will plant those. I'm not going to plant them exactly right there again, like I said, because there could still be eggs in the soil or remnants of parts of the roots. So I will just move it over here a little bit.
Yeah, those chimes are...
They are very loud.
It's a windy day today.
Okay, so again, they don't like to be deep. They just like to have their long roots covered. This part they like above ground. So I'm just going to put this over here. Put this underneath. This is from that one. And cover those up. That I broke off. I don't see any roots coming out of here, so I am not going to even attempt to save this one. This one, the first one that I did, beautiful roots. No damage here, so this one I will also plant. Not over there where that one was, but perhaps you may notice that On this side, there are fewer iris, and on that side, there are more. That's because this side of the bed was attacked by the iris borer. And as you go through, that's when you start checking. And again, the sooner you get to the ones that are infected, the better your whole bed will be. Well, we hope you enjoyed our first day in the garden. If you look here, spring. If you look over there, still winter. But it's been wonderful working out here and breathing fresh air and having the sun beat down on us for the first time since October, when that's when it got this warm in the past. So my little buddy Pepper and I wish you a farewell. If you enjoyed the video, please give us a thumbs up and keep your love growing. That's what we all need. You gonna pull weeds?
Connect with us on YouTube.